Hi, I'm Brian English, Wappler forum name Hyperbytes, and in this module I'm going to be creating the server action that is required in order to perform that registration process from the data sent from the registration form that we created in our previous module. So in this case we're going to create a workflow, and within that workflow section we're going to create an API. Now, I like to keep APIs into folders just so they're a little easy to manage before you get hundreds and you can't find anything. So I'm going to create now the folder, and we're just going to call this registration. What we'll actually do is we'll put all of our registration, login, logout, etc. API actions within this folder. So I'm going to add an API action, and I'm going to call this register. So the first thing we need to do is just to pull those inputs from our registration form and create them within our register action. Now you can just manually do that if you want, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use a quick shortcut by pulling those values from the register page itself. So they're going to be in views, that's where all of your content pages are, register, and click open. Within that is found the register one form, and if we click on import from form, what you'll see is that not only have we pulled over the details of the inputs for this action, but also the validations as well. And unless there's any particular reason, there's no reason at all why you shouldn't just leave those validations in place. The only one I'm going to take out is password 2. So we take that out purely on the basis that we're not actually going to be using that at all. So we can highlight it and then delete that action step and just remove that, because that's a validation that takes place at the client end and we don't need to repeat that at a later stage. So we've got our basic action, and the most basic registration process would be to do nothing more than just insert those details into the users table. So we've got our user, and so we've got the first name, last name, email and password, and those names, you see, match the field names that we created, the inputs, and by convenience, because we did it that way, they also match the column names. And that's why I said try and match them, because Wappler will automatically assume that the input, the post input for your insert, will actually match the column name. The only one I'm going to look at there is date sign up. If you remember, we actually put a default of now into that, so there's absolutely no need to write a value into that. But we could have actually just said we want to send it the value of now, or now universal time constant, and manually update that. But we actually can just delete it completely, because that will be handled at database level. Let's save that. That will then create our user, but obviously once we create a user, they need to have a basic authority. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to give them a role as well. So again, that's a simple database insert. Insert action is going to be into the role table this time. And what we need to do is insert the user ID that was allocated in this first step, and then a role. And that's really as simple to do again in Wappler. What we do is, it's obviously not going to come from a post. But if you look at that first insert, you'll see that returns two values. It returns the identity that was allocated to that ID, and actually the number of rows that were affected, which obviously would normally be one unless it's a multi-row insert. So what we need to do is to say we want that user ID field to be the new identity that was allocated to that user in the previous stage. And I'm just going to give the role of member. I'll just put a fixed role in there for the member and save. And that's most basic level. That's all we need to do. However, a couple of little things we've got to think about. Big one is what happens if somebody registers twice using the same email? We would end up with two users with the same email, possibly the same password, different passwords. We really do not want the same email to be registered twice. And we can do that or prevent that happening by using the validate stage. So right at the start of that action, we're going to add an action. We're going to use the validator. What we're going to say is our validate options are, we change that name, I'll just leave it at validate one. What we're doing is we're validating the email. Linked field, that is the name of the field in the actual page itself, that registration form. That's just purely there so it can send error messages back if required to the page, so it can display a message saying that it's already been registered or whatever. And our rule is that database, it does not exist in the user table in the column email. So if the post email value exists already in the database in the column of email, then it will send the message back saying value already exists in the database. And I'm just going to change that to email already exists in the database, just to make that a little bit more meaningful. So we save that. Now we know that we have no duplicates allowed. Our basic database insert to insert that user, and then we can afterwards give that person a role. And that is the registration process at its most simple. So in the next section, we're going to be looking at how to make it a little bit harder for those dreaded sign-up bots that exist all over the internet, so that we can make sure that we stop automated sign-ups, or at least help reduce them and stop the spammers from getting into our system. So I hope to see you soon.